right?
Got it.
How long does it shoot?
1.5 to 5 minutes.
1.5 to 5 minutes. I'll have time then to get my camera.
Come on, do something 4 miles away, bro.
Like your father, it takes a while to build up a head of steam. But when it blows,
you know, Dad, that's the first thing everybody's going to hear when they watch this tape.
Oh, wow.
Well, that's it. Time to go.
Looks like it's pee.
I think this is.
Shut up, man.
Oh, you said that, though.
Here we go.
Yeah, here it is.
Here we go. Oh,
wow.
Wow. I know.
Oh my gosh.
Wow.
They predicted right on time, didn't they?
He really had one today. He just had to go.
I drove all this for that.
Immediately.
So, Brian.
Shh. Oh, are you taking that? If you jumped in that, you'd die.
This is a mud pot.
Got a little too close to that humeral, didn't he? That's a wart. That might be. It has teeth and teeth out.
I think it's more like a deer. Mom, which is the humeral?
This right here. No, why is this different than what we just saw? It was like a humeral.
I don't know. I don't know why it's there, because there's still mud in there. There's more of a concentration of water in this fumarole, which gives it it's a constant bubbling up.
Here we go. Gases. Steam, carbon dioxide, and a little hydrogen sulfide rush from the earth through this vent. The steam comes from rain or snow water that seeps down to the zone of very hot rock. Upon contact with the rock, it splashes into steam. The sudden increase in volume, nearly 1,000 times, produces pressure which drives the gases from the vent. How's it different than a...
Let me see. This is red spouter. I don't know what this thing is, but it looks cool, so I decided to videotape it.
Well, that's bison droppings.
Well, okay, we're going to end the videotape now.
I'm going to back down on some of these because these shots are going to look a lot older.
This is what, Mom? Mud geyser?
Mud geyser.
I'm going to guess the geysers are right over here.
Is it a geyser?
Well, it
was. Sure does smell, doesn't it?
During the 1970s, this pool had cooled and lost enough of its carbon dioxide supply to allow a thick, lush mat of green, grassy plants to cover most of its surface. But these plants were killed by heat released in the 1978 to 79 local earthquake swarm. The pool heated up to 145 degrees, too hot and agitated for the mass to survive. In recent years, the average temperature is back between 120 and 130 degrees. This feature has slowly shifted some 200 feet south from the point at which it first formed. The spring which feeds nearby Sour Lake was much more active before Black Dragon's Cauldron was formed. We can speculate that underground changes diverted heat energy from Sour Lake to form this seething mass of black mud.
Stop it.
heads. Vaping.
What is this still? Brian?
This is where you'd stay if you
most definitely.
If you gave up your tent, you'd give it up for this, right?
Definitely.
Where are the rooms?
Giving.
I'm safe. We didn't do that.
Come on, you're both on.
Hey!
Well, how